Yo, Adam Saxon here with Guy in a Cube, and welcome to 2018. I hope you guys had a wonderful holiday, and you may have noticed something's a little different here. I actually moved into a new house. This is my new office. I'm still working on getting everything set up. I've got a lot of plans. It's a big room. You're gonna see some changes going on over the next couple months. So stay tuned on that. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button just to stay up to date with the latest videos from both Patrick and myself. With that, let's dig into the roundup. David Eldersveld has a blog post talking about fonts and Power BI and just bringing up something that's not generally talked about. I think some of it is more assumed than not. And this is just choosing the right font for your reports and your audience, knowing your audience. So he looks at the different fonts that are available inside of Power BI that you can utilize inside of your reports. If this isn't something you're familiar with, I highly recommend you check out this blog post. I will have links down in the description below, along with all the other links in this week's roundup. Brad Marshall over at Power Pivot Pro has a blog post talking about dynamic attributes for use inside of your Power BI reports. This is really all about changing the way you view the data in your report. So he's got some examples where he shows you the old way of doing it, and you may have to lay out like three or four different charts to get what it is you're looking for. But what he walks through is the capability of actually setting up attributes in a way that you can just use a slicer and it'll change the view of what you're looking at in your chart dynamically. This may sound familiar, and if you've been watching the videos, Patrick LeBlanc also had a video on this not too long ago. I'll link to it up here, and you can go check that out as well, and he shows how to do a similar approach. So if this is something you're interested in, if you've been struggling with reports and you've got different attributes that you want to report on, but you want to change that or let the user select what they actually look at, take a look at this blog post and check out what Brad has for you. Jason Thomas has got a blog where he looks at how you can actually use images inside of your data model inside of Power BI. I feel Patrick somewhere raising an eyebrow of interest on this one. We've had a lot of discussions about what are the options that we can use to get images inside of our reports. From a data perspective, we've always said that, look, you've got to do it by way of a URL out on the internet and it'll just go and grab it. I know Patrick's been looking at, well, why can't I just store an image inside a SQL database and use it there? So what Jason's come up with is a way that you can convert an image to Base64 and then add that into your data model, add a prefix on top of it, set it to an image URL, and boom, image is inside of your report. I think this is a pretty interesting technique. I would love to hear whatever comments that you have on this, or if you have a different approach, and I'm sure Jason would love to hear about that too. So if this is something you're interested in and you want to add images into your data model, be sure to check out the blog post down in the description below for details. There is another contest that you can participate in. This one is a year in review 2017, a data story. So if you want to put a data story together for the year of 2017, you can go and do that inside of a Power BI report, submit that to the data stories gallery, and make sure you tag it year in review contest. You can submit these entries up until January 31st at 11:59 p.m. Pacific time, at which point the contest is over and selections will be made. So I hope to see a lot of submissions, and I'm curious to see what you're going to put together. The Power BI desktop team put together a video just highlighting the last year and just saying Happy New Year to the community. It was kind of cool to see all the actual developers who have worked on Power BI desktop signing off on the features that they've worked on, and some of them just sharing some of their thoughts and what they hope to see in the future. If you haven't seen the video yet, be sure to check out the blog post down in the description below. It's embedded inside of the blog post. And keep giving your feedback to the Power BI desktop team. They are actively listening and working on improvements for the future. All right, what was your favorite item? Go and leave that down in the comments below and let us know. For me, it was the Base64 imaging that Jason Thomas talked about. I know in some cases it may not be practical just because of the model size, but I thought the technique was very cool and it gives you another option for using images in your report. So that's awesome. If you like this video, be sure to hit that thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If you're new here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.